So today we're going to begin a series on restoring a Hallicrafters SX-99. Now this unit was actually given to me by a friend at a ham fest because he saw the kind of work that I did on other ones. But mainly, most of these, they're pretty common units. You can find them at auction in the range of $100 to $200, plus or minus shipping and things like that. This one is in good shape, especially the front panel. The silver area is in good condition. I suspect it hasn't been opened up very much. Most of the time you find these things, they've been opened up a lot. We'll see. It has the original Hallicrafters tubes in it. So the only thing that I've done before I started the filming was I removed those two little knobs. Two of these, one will be a lot of trouble. These are not my favorite kind of knobs, actually. They have a set screw in them. The Hallicrafter set screws are not hexagonal. They're not the typical set screw. They are a little square, and those are small size too. You can get a set of these on the auction site. But all you're doing is trying to get this one size that you need to get these screws off, and they're not easy. Especially, it seems like they've been in place for a very long time. This is a very small square type Allen wrench, not a hexagonal. So, we're going to get as far as we can in this first episode in disassembly of the unit. So let me get this thing arranged so we can get it started. There is a proper way to remove the screws and remove the chassis from inside this, I will say, generation of boat anchors. Let me wipe some WD-40 off. If you need to remove or insert screws in these heavy units in a weight neutral condition. And the best way, in my experience, has been to begin by removing the bottom screws first. These are all original screws. They're flathead. Amazing screws on the trim part, and they have been removed before, I can tell. They're pretty loose. Of course, some of the WD-40, I went ahead and WD-40'd the knobs because that would be a huge time consumer, and you'll be sitting here waiting on the WD-40 to work. And this particular one is so frozen on, we're going to have to remove the front cover with that and detach the switch from the chassis and take the cover out with that still attached. And hopefully I can get some good leverage at that point to remove that set screw. If not, you may have to soak it in a strange position or whatever in WD-40 for a long period of time. Okay, so the bottom screws are out. Then the next thing you do, excuse me, in the front of the camera, is you're going to take the lid screws off. It goes pretty fast, actually. Even though this is a light boat anchor, comparison to the SX-71 that I just restored. That one is a 50 pounds and 2 hernias lift, and this is only a 30 pound and 1 hernia lift. So the back screws come out. This is an immensely useful tool for Hallicrafters. They seem to be using standard screws for most of their units. So why not get a socket wrench that just fits every time. I'll get this one real quick. Trick to this, hope that didn't break the, and it's so rusted up it doesn't really work. But when we get this reconditioned, that won't be a problem. You'll be able to pop it on the sides. Now the lid is off. And it'll be a while before we get that back on. Alright, now is the time we take the screws out of the sides. And it looks like we may have to remove this now. I've already loosened this. This is the standby receive switch. And it's held on by just a nut that goes around the bracket, and I've loosened it already. And that will permit me to get in to the and remove the screws to the bracket, which will allow the whole switch assembly to come out and get in here. Yeah. With the front face. That's when those things don't work. You can't get the face off. I say the set screws on those small knobs. Put on some light since I can't see what I'm doing without it. Yeah, we're just going to have to use a flathead screwdriver here. I may have to WD-40 this too. Take up your time on this. But I got it. This one. There's two screws that hold the bracket to the two position standby receive rotational switch here. So we'll be able to take the face off with the switch still inside the face. And that will give me better leverage to it without scratching up the surface of the radio face. Yeah, that's almost a use. there's always some kind of little loop thrown in at you when you're doing these things. Wire cutters. Okay, stand by. Receipt switch is free. Actually, I might be able to get that off now. Let's see if we can get that done. Now that I got a good angle here, it just is, it's really a touch. It's been soaking in WD-40 and it's still resisting. I may have to actually soak it in the solution of it for a period of time. It is so frozen. We'll worry about that later. Alright. So I have already loosened some of these knobs. And these regular Allen wrenches work fine in these front knobs. The other ones. There we go. Although I've got one knob for one unit that the excuse me that the set screw is so frozen that it will never come out. And I've even tried drilling and everything else. And it just sits there. Nothing. You can strip these things. What I do is I replace them. New ones. When I refurbish these radios because of this issue with these hex screws stripping and so forth. Okay, this one is really doesn't want to come loose. This one's loose. This one's loose. That one's loose. The main tuning are usually pretty easy. Leverage when you're doing this. Okay. And here. These will all be cleaned up and prettied up. The orange indicator always gets, is a victim of the, on these knobs, is a victim of the cleaning processes. So I use my art supplies to, this is totally let me get a get the camera up here. Let's take a look inside here. It's worth looking at. We'll just leave it running. Okay. So, you see, this is the protective cover over the S meter to keep you from getting out like 300 volts while you're playing around, moving fingers around inside the radio. There we go. That's been undisturbed. It's never been touched. I'm doing a lousy job of I do not get awards for cinematography. Okay, there it is. That's new stuff. I mean, it looks like new. So, moving my light out of the way here. Turn it off. Okay. So these are original Hallicrafters tubes. and it's got a lot of rust, small, you know, surface rust on the inside, which will get all cleaned up. It does not look disturbed at all. It looks like it's probably sat on the shelf for a long time. I'll put this back on the tripod. Okay. So, we take a... I think this is the right size. Yep. We take one of these and remove the screws to the S meter. You saw that just a minute ago. You don't have to see this. I mean, you know what's going on. There's a positive and a negative. The red is positive lead. And we talked about the S meter in one of my earlier videos. There's a reverse, turn my light back up, reverse indicating ammeter, which only reads like 1 milliamp or 2 milliamps or something like that. Okay? And it's calibrated. Alright, so this comes out. I'm going to be able to take the face off with the S meter attached. We'll later take that out and recondition that a little bit. Okay, so we're ready to do the front face, and we'll start by removing, do this first, then the side screws, because there isn't anything that holds this face if the side screws are removed, then you'll put all the weight on these switches. So we'll take this process. This is not the best design here because there's not a lot of distance on that. And anyway, just out talking. You don't have to remove that one yet, that's right. Now these you do. Put some WD-40 on it. Needle nose on this. Seeing so many of these stripped. Front face, if I don't scratch it up too much, is in really good shape. It's not rusted or pitted or anything. There we go. Once loosened, simply take it free. See if we can pick that out with some tweezers. There we go. And this one screws. By the way, you probably didn't, may or may not have noticed, the way to get the face off easily is to have it leaning over the edge of the table. Okay, this was too large. WD-40, this one, I don't think. Just ease it back. This one goes. See. That's it. That's what we're looking for here. There we go. Alright. We got this here. And now we take the side screws out. And these are the original screws. Amazing. Well, it hasn't been modified, which is interesting. So you often see this unit modified by hands using it in, back in the 50s and 60s, or a newspaper mod, or, I mean a magazine mod or something like that. The first one I got had a, I think it was two or three extra tube sockets in it. All that went out. Yeah. Made for nice ventilation holes into the chassis, but all of that was gone when I finished with it. Okay, so we're going to get this cover off. Take a look. Probably in front of the camera right now, sorry. We're just removing screws. Alright, all screws have been removed, and there we go. If we're able to, oh, yes. The pilot lights. Dial lights. There we go. And now it comes out very nice and easy. And there's the bracket still attached to the switch there, which we'll have to work on removing that knob. We'll just place this right here. So here we have what it looks like without the front face on. It looks and not much. It's gonna have I see a tiny cheek. Okay, we're going to have fun in the recap and the reconditioning of the electronics. Okay, so the next step is I'm going to remove... it has a set screw. I have a long one somewhere. We're going to take the dials off. We're going to take everything off of this thing. So turn this around. This goes into the do not disturb drawer until time comes to put these back on and do in the reassembly. Yeah, it doesn't want to move like anything else. Everything's been attached for a very long time. We're going to have to WD-40 the dial. I don't want to do that. Let's see if I can get this one. Oh, there's two of them. Remember. You have to turn it all the way around to get to it. Let's make sure that's not going to come out. You can't see that from the camera angle, but almost had the set screw in what Larry from the hills of Tennessee calls the floor monster. Get to that. There's two set screws per dial. Very good. Now it comes out nicely. There's one. I'm actually getting ahead of myself. I haven't taken the chassis out of the case yet. We'll do that next. Okay. Alright, this goes into the do not disturb drawer over here. And we sit until the thing is ready to reassemble. Okay. Now, to remove the unit from the case, you get all the tools out of the way first. And then I lift, the bottom has been attached. No. What did I do? I forgot three screws. Okay. After all that lecture about doing things in a weight neutral position, I got a screw I forgot. So I'm going to have to lift it and pull. Keep from things. Let's see. That was down. Oh, there's a better way. There is always a better way. It's already getting lighter. I do like that. Turn it around this way. We'll just lean it over the edge. There's just one screw I forgot. It's right here. Because that way when you're doing it upside down. And because it's weight neutral, I can turn it with my hand. So, the best way to deal with this is, we'll turn around the way I was going to do it. So let's say I didn't forget that screw and we were ready to do this. We would lift up by the transformer. There we go. And I can put my hand over here. You have to clear some things in the bottom of the chassis while you do it this way. And that comes out like this, and you can pull the case out from under the chassis. Now, I've got that facing away. Let me finish the manipulation of this, and we'll come back. Okay. Here's what she looks like outside of the case. Pretty dirty. And one thing I did was I moved all of the variable capacitors back into their full meshed position so that if I mess them up, I'll mess them all up, not just some of it. Okay, so now we are actually at a hole point. And I will show that to you right now. Oh, yes. Take a look at there. Tiny chiefs everywhere. And bumblebees to go with them. That's called a tiny chief. It's a paper capacitor hidden by red plastic. And it's just as bad as if it were a paper wax capacitor. And then the bumblebees are pretty much the same. This has never been disturbed. How about this will be fun to work on. Looky there. Wow. I was all set to do all the wiring again. I'm not sure I will now. It's all in great condition. Man. This is going to be a nothing burger as far as the restoration is concerned. Except maybe the biggest problem might be removing this knob here. You can see it. Anyway. Yeah, that looks good. Well, there is something I do. I take DC resistances from every tube pin to either to ground if it's a if it's not connected to the B plus or the not connected to B plus or to the B plus if it is connected to B plus. And the point behind this is when I finish the look at the beauty, the rusted, well, you just take that out and soak that a little bit, and look, the wax is still in there. Well, no, okay, somebody's been into it with it. Man, I bet you half of these resistors are in good shape too. I may save some money. This one is one you'll get rid of every time, and these roundies. It doesn't even have roundies. I don't think. Turn my light on here. Man, what great condition is it? Oh, somebody's put in, this is not a standard issue. So anyway, well, maybe it is. 12, you know, it's got a Hallicrafters part number on it. How about that? Well, this will be a great unit when it's restored. I don't know if any of the tubes are any good. They're looked rusted, but looky there. There's a lot of some sweating on this one. There's a roundy right there. Get rid of those. Look, the mic is looking good condition. See, a lot of these are, and this is the pitch control, and it's nothing but a slug on a brass, screw, long screw, and these get bent a lot, but this looks straight. Oh boy, okay. Let me come back in a minute and I'll show you what we're up to here. This is a whole point, actually. We're going to take DC resistances, and that's what's going to save my neck in checking things out before it gets powered up, because we'll take them again just before we power up. Yeah, this is a Mark 1D. In the Mark 1D, they put the crystal over here, which is a lot easier to get. This is so much easier. Wow! They finally learned how to wire this thing by the fourth run. Yeah, this we'll get this done in a day. No, not at all. It'll take me a long time because I can't do this every day. All right, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so I got things arranged here to do a test, do the resistance measurements. This is the measurements that I took on the first rebuild that I did on an SX-99. Hallicrafters put these in the SX-71 service manuals, and maybe one or two other units, maybe a 40 or something like that. They're immensely useful in when you're checking your work to make sure that you wired everything up correctly and didn't get something messed up. So I go through this when I've finished doing all the rework, to see and make sure that we'll have something close to the same wiring, so to speak, from a resistance point of view, before we even put the first bit of voltage to the unit. Now, what I'm going to do today is I'm going to do the as found measurement that will replace. These numbers are ideal numbers after the first rebuild. And so I'll put the as found, and then we'll do a third round, which is the as built numbers down the road. I tell you what, this, all the problems I had with the first rebuild were addressed by run 1D, which is what this is. I mean, all the tough places I had to get into, no problem. We won't have any problem cleaning switches like I expected to have. So, anyway, this will be an easy thing to work on and to get up to snuff. I guess if you're going to start out doing this, you want to have a rough receiver to do it with. And the first restoration I did on an SX-79, all these wires, you couldn't see any of the color coding. It was dark and full of mold and all these extra holes in the chassis, and it was a rough piece of work, and I only paid $40 for it, and it was only worth $40 at the time. But right now it's a top performer, so that just goes to show, if you're going to learn something, learn on the hard one first, I guess, is the lesson there. So all we're going to do, and I'm not going to do it on camera, is we're just going to take resistance measurements and record that on this sheet before we proceed further. And we're not going to do much more on this video anyway. So you just take like this. That's probably, that's 22000. So it's probably over. Well, let's see if you can connect that. Make sure you have it. Okay, it's not in. This may not be a good choice of probes. So that's on voltage. I want it on, oh, I've got it backwards. Okay, there was something going on here. All right, let's see what this one is. So 225, and that's a 22.5 kilo K, and this is a 22K resistor. So I'm not even sure this radio got used. Maybe I ought to just put it all back in and see if it runs. No, we're not going to do that. I don't care if they're all perfect tiny chiefs. I don't want them in this radio. So we're going to make these recordings, and then we'll come back and wrap up this video. Okay, so I've done all the measurements. And the one thing that is doubtful about it is on the rectifier tube, the filament is showing infinity, which is telling me there may be an open filament to the rectifier, which is, in this my case, not a problem because I have spares. So that string looks pretty good, but we're going to take it out because we have to remove the main condenser and clean it. And we'll have to use a little coaxing right here. This is, it's like working on a pristine radio that's been in like Rumpelstiltskin asleep for 30 years. And perhaps the problem with the main transformer is why. Oh, that gives me a clue as to how they got that done. Comes out like this. Of course, we will not be able to, well, we might leave that in. Okay. They'll at least tell me how they did it. I did mine a little different when I re-strung it up. We kind of like the way they did it. They are the manufacturer, for that matter. What do they know? Let's pull this out a little bit. And we can get the string out here. There we go. Now that makes it easy. So they tied it that way. Oh, I like that. I'll remember that. That's a nice technique. This is the first time I've seen the way the factory does it. It's always somebody else that got to it first. The string's in not too bad a condition. They ought to know. Okay. So we'll take this, spread. Oh, yeah. What a clever idea. I didn't do that either. They don't put things in pulleys for nothing, right? They don't talk about that little thing when they do the streaming instructions in the service manual. This little thing is actually a catch to keep it from slipping. It makes sense. I don't know why I didn't think to use it. I do. I do know why I didn't think to use it, but we don't need to repeat that here. Okay. So, then these brackets come out here. And they will be de-rusted and so forth. We're going to have a lot of good cleaning to do on the top, but almost nothing to do on the underside. It's amazing. Now I know how they actually made these things originally. This comes right out. Nice and shiny where the rust didn't get to it. Look at these Hallicrafters. Okay, so that comes out. Then I heard something. The floor monster, as Larry says, catch something. Oh, there it is. It's a washer on the floor. Don't forget the washer on the floor. Don't forget the washer on the floor. Don't forget the washer on the floor. All right, so this comes out here. Now we're not going to remove the tubes of the main condenser today. Actually, this is enough for today. We'll clean some things up. I'll work on that switch a little bit, or at least get it soaking. And then we'll pick this up in the next video. This is Hallicrafters Rehabs, and we're working on a new one. Thanks for watching. So I took the tubes out, cleaned them, and put them in the box. I've got all the parts in various bags inside the box. And I, with a great deal of care, you can get a contact. It's actually very corroded inside those tube sockets. And the transformer ohmed out. So our transformer is probably going to be good. This rust does not clean up with Ollie Oxy Clean or whatever. And so we'll be painting the surface or the outside of the chassis. The inside will not need hardly any. I'll just wipe it down. And for the switch, excuse all the movings around, I'm soaking the switch in WD-40. I'll do that overnight. I'll either have a totally corroded and useless switch, or it will come loose. So with that, we'll conclude this video. So while we are listening to Radio Television Guinean, I'll say thanks for watching, and thanks for the new subscribers, and please subscribe if you want to continue. Thank you. Bye-bye.